microelectromechanical systems, MEMS, are tiny devices that are used in many communication devices, in your cell phone, for any kind of sensing humidity, pressure. Also microphones, there are many MEMS devices, so they are used everywhere. In the MEMS devices, one major challenge is the nonlinearity in the system. So for example, if you have a ruler, you want to have uniform spacing on the ruler. You don't want to have non-uniform spacing. And so we try to create a mechanism that makes this MEMS devices linear so that the performance is predictable and also better controllable. Triboelectricity is converting friction to electricity. So if you rub a balloon on your hair, that generates static electricity. And the same thing for a smaller scale. So we actually tested these triboelectric generators in a centimeter scale. Also, we recently made them in the micro scale. These are two different areas, the triboelectricity and the MEMS devices, and the combination of that actually create very highly innovative devices. The reason for that is that triboelectricity is a high voltage mechanism, very low current, and on the other hand, the MEMS devices, which are based on electrostatic devices, they are very low power, so there is a big synergy between these two systems. The research that we started, I think, is just the beginning of many useful devices that can benefit from this combination. So we call them smart knee implants because they provide load measurement without any power. So they do not require any external power. Once people walk, we have the contact and separation on the triboelectric layers. And that contact and separation converts to electricity. And because the voltage that they produce is proportional to the amount of load that they receive, we can provide load measurement. And then what we need extra is just to have a circuit that converts that analog signal to a digital signal and then relate it to the amount of load that it receives. And then providers can provide some guidance to patients to avoid certain movements or do something else instead that doesn't cause wear and tear in the knee implant. My name is Sherry Towfighian. I'm an associate professor in mechanical engineering department at Binghamton University.